architecture in the SD-Access. Now this is the SD-Access deployment. So in SD-Access deployments, of course I have, this is the user, user A. Of course I have the user B. Goal is that how this user A and B will communicate. So they are connecting with edge node. Edge node. There's a link. This is also connected with, let's say, edge number two. Edge two. Right now, user do not have any informations. It is only connecting this, let's say gig 01. So these edge devices that I'm connecting with the help of the intermediate node, which is known as underlay node. So ULAY, like this. And then I need one more node, which is known as control node. This is my control node. Then you have this, the border node. It's one more component, which is known as a border node. Border node is providing access to this shared services. So that is my, the switch, or I will say distributed switch, which is providing access to different segments. Where distributed switch is connecting to shared services. Where the first I need to be provisioned here. Of course, I need ICE. ICE, which is providing the authentication authorization services. The second here, I need, of course, DNAC. DNAC. And then I also need the DHCP DNS, DHCP DNS NTP server. And to manage this, to access all this network, of course, I need also management PC, which is I can connect as long as I have the connectivity. So management PC. Okay, so here is, to build this, I have, these are my, of course, layer three links. These are the layer three links, layer three links. Assuming that you are building this network, so underlay network is built where the each device is provisioned with their. So you have also configured the loopback interfaces, loopback zero. I have also the loopback zero here. So in this network now, the first you have to be select your the, of course, the IP pool here. I mean the underlay IP infrastructure. Let's say you're using 10.130.0.0. This is the underlay pool. Along with you're using, for example, ISIS as a routing protocols. That segment is using, for example, 10.1.1.0/24. So you need reachability. That means all the edge node need reachability. All this, the shared services as well. So that border node is providing that reachability. Assume that is using my IP number is 1, that one is 2, this one is 3, this is 4. So underlay is provision here. And once you're provisioning your underlay network, this is the physical infrastructure. Then before the end user will get the IP address, because end user is a part of the overlay network. So we'll build the overlay network. And for the overlay network, the DNAC is using the concept of virtual network, VN. So virtual network is similar to what we have the VRF. So the physical infrastructure is look like this. This is the physical layout. But logical networks, assuming that here, my plan is that I'm going to be build my overlay network where I want to segregate. So assuming that I have the two department here. So I want to segregate my the corporate traffic from the guest. That means here in the overlay, when you're going to be provisioning the overlay networks. So we'll create here the first minimums. You're going to be create your minimum to minimums. You're going to be create 2 VN. So one for my corporate employees, second for my the guest employees. For examples for the corporate employees, you're using, let's say this is my campus VN. This is what you are creating the VRF, campus VN. This is the virtual network, and you're creating the guest VN. And within the campus VN, let's say this is my, let's say that is the employee PC. That one is my, the contractor PC, contractor. As an example, it's contractor network. Where both this PC belongs to same VRF. That means within a campus. That means this is I have the one virtual network. This is my the campus VN. In the campus VN, you're creating within a campus VN. So this is a VRF. So VRF need the IP pool. So you're creating here, let's say employee IP pool can create a contractor IP pool. For example, the employee is using the IP pool as, let's say 172.16.1.0. As an example, that one is using 172.16.2.0/24. So contractor is using that IP pool. That means within the campus VN, you're creating this different pool. So each IP pool is what we have is equal to VLAN. Each IP pool is equal to VLAN that is going to be created in this campus VN. So all these things you're doing through the DNAC is a provisioning phase. Where the goal is that how this now the user A can communicate with user B. This is where the concept you need to understand for the SD access deployment, which means first of all, these users, so that user A before the user A can access anything, or will get the IP address, the first the user, all the user is need to be authenticate, which means before you will start your before you make sure that the user can communicate with my this SD access net environment. So how the user is going to be authenticate? This is with the help of ICE as a server. So ICE will act as a AAA server. That means here, when you're going to be do the deployment, of course, the new deployment or the existing deployments, make sure that your ICE server is deployed and up and running in the production environment. This means the step number one, we will make sure that you have the ICE engine is connected with my network and that is accessible via this the network or this the campus network. Because in the step number one, user is need to be authenticate and authorize. Authenticate and authorization. So this portion is done by the ICE, which means in order to do this, the authentication and authorize, step number one, ICE will be running or ICE need to be provision. In the step number two, of course, ICE integration is also required with DNAC. ICE integration with DNAC. Okay, so when I say the authentication and authorization with the help of ICE, so ICE is using the concept of, so here, the simple view is like this. So goal is that how the user is, user A, that need to be access my resources. Before to access resources, it is important that the user which is connecting with my network that must be authenticated and authorized, which means user A is connected with this edge node. And that edge node is connecting with the help of border node. Edge node is connecting with the help of border node, my ICE server. Let's say ICE is using IP number 10.1.1.1, which means here, ICE identity service engine is providing one of the main service is AAA, authentication, authorization, and accounting, along with other features you have like profiling, posture management. So ICE is a complete solution to secure your network, posture management. It is providing the bring your own devices, BYOD management, all these things with the help of the ICE. The major functionality of the AAA is, the ICE is to provide this authentication, therefore, in order to provide authentication, the mechanism this is using, which is known as 802.1x, .1x, where for the .1x terminology, so you may have the .1x based authentication, because you may have the MAC based authentication, you may have the web authentication, so different mechanisms for authentication, where the .1x is in the end devices if support. So this is the most secure method. So layer two, securing your the layer 2 traffic, MAF in the absence of the devices which is do not support .1x, for those you have the MAV, for example, printer, scanner. Your devices, if do not have the support for .1x MAV, there is also the layer 3 authentication is also available. But the goal is that end user is need to be authenticated. The authentication is based on these mechanisms, where for the .1x, the protocols which is you're using that is known as EAP, Extensible Authentication Protocols, EAP, along with RADIUS, which means for the 888 terminology or with the .1x terminology, this device which is need to be accessed or connect with my network is known as a supplicant. Supplicant, that edge node is act as an authenticator. This is my simple layer 2 link, where I'm going to be take the EAP frame. And EAP frame is received by the authenticator, which is from authenticator to I server, which is known as a AAA server. You're using the protocol. In this section, the protocol is RADIUS. That means here, the edge node is need to be, in order to take that the RADIUS frame, edge node need reachability to this I server. And that you're providing with the the underlay infrastructure. Through this, the underlay infrastructures, you have that reachability to this ICE server. So for the authentication, of course, when we go for the authentications, we have the different methods. So there is a phase approach is provided by the .1x architecture, where we have the step number ones. We have also capability to provide no authentication at all, although that is not giving an advantage, but that step is also is available. So during provisioning, you can say that I don't want to authenticate, so no authentication. You can provide authentication, but at simply you're saying that simply I don't want to authenticate, but monitor. So that is you have the open authentication, open base. So phase-based deployment. Then you have also the ACL based authentication. You have also the close mode, which is known as a .1x mode. But that capability is given to the administrator that what type of authentications or the template you want to select during authentication so that the end user can authenticate. But here the I'm giving the that process is happen again automatic. I mean, the authentication process, you as administrator is going to be select that, okay, what type of template is intent-based networking is provided by the SD-Access environment. So once the user is authenticated, so then it will get the step number 2, authorization. And the authorizations, of course, it is again the responsibility of the V. So far, the user is authenticated. Next steps, they need to be know that I belongs to which VLAN. So VLAN allocation along with secure group tag, security group tag. So those things is provided at the time of authorization. So step number 1, user is need to be authenticated. In step number 2, it will get the VLAN informations, which means authentication and authorization. That responsibility is done by ICE server. Which means here, before the end user can get, so make sure that your ICE is up and running. The second step is that ICE is integrate, ICE integration with DNS center. And step number two, once the user will get the VLAN informations, the next step is that they will get the IP, which means that the goal is done by the DHCP. So now there is a role of the DHCP server. So user need IP address, and that IP address is provided by the DHCP server, which is available in MyNet. This is also one of the examples of the shared server, DHCP service, that is residing outside from the fabric, campus fabric. So campus fabric means the collection of edge border control node along with wireless LAN controller. So let's say this DHCP server is listening for the IP address 10.1.1.2. You have the pool is, so pool is configured in the DHCP server. With the following pools you have, let's say, for example, the user is supposed to get the IP number from 172.16.1.0. So in DHCP servers, you're going to give all this information, network, what will be the gateway. This is act as a gateway. So gateway is applied or configured on interface SBI. Which means now, assuming that you have the DHCP server is provisioned, that means now the client is, user A is getting IP address from the DHCP server by using the process called DORA, discover, offer, request and acknowledgement. With the additional steps here, the edge node, the first of all, edge node is act as a DHCP relay agent. So edge node is act as a DHCP relay agent, which means the moment the VLAN is provisioned by, the moment you create the pool, IP pool, it will provision the gateway here. Suppose you're creating this IP pool, it will create the SBI with this number 172.16.1.1 on this VLAN interface, on a VLAN interface. And that VLAN interface is also providing the DHCP information with the help of the helper address. So all that thing is automatically provisioned helper address. So DHCP relay agent, where the edge node is also act as a or enabling the service called DHCP snooping. So all the best practices, which is you thinking in the traditional environment, all those things is automatically provisioned by the DNAC. So edge node is also act as a DHCP snooping, which means it is also protecting your client that the other than the company authorized servers, no one can, the client cannot get IP address from any other server. But the point is that here, all this information is automatically provisioned. We as administrators or in the production environments, we will verify that what is going on or how it is going to be provisioned all these steps by understanding the flow or the SD access deployment workflow. But the point is that here, the overall, the concept is that how the user will get IP address. Once user will get IP address, how it is going to be to registration with the control node. Once the control plane is built, so finally, how the user is communicating with one another. So IP address is assigned by the DHCP server. So it will get the IP address. Assume it will get IP address from the server is 172.16.1.100. The moment user A will get IP address, now it is the responsibility of this, the edge node, to register this, the user, IP and MAC address. With this, the control plane node, and the control plane node here, which is provisioned by the administrators or the SD access administrator. So finally, here in the step number 3, user registration with, once the user will get IP address, so user registration with control node. And how? That is with the help of the protocol Lisp. Which means here, in these examples, suppose user A is getting IP address 1.100 from the DHCP server, user B is getting 2.100, user A MAC address is A, user B MAC address is B. That means now, they are sending their information. The moment they get IP address, so edge node will get this information. Edge node will build the local table, local MAC table, local the routing table, or more specifically, it will build the VRF aware table here. Assuming that I have the campus VN, so you will see that there is a campus VN is provisioned by this edge node. But when this will get this information, it simply take this IP and MAC information and tell to control node. So the control node will get this information that I have this 172.16. Notice it will get host based route. So 1.100 along with their MAC number. From edge one, so whosoever IP address, so whatever the IP address is, for example, it is getting from this pool 131.1 from the underlay pool. That one is getting 10.131.2 as a host route. So these are the IPs act as a routing locator for the Lisp perspective. The same thing will happen to this user. We will send this frame. Edge node is telling this information to control node that, okay, I have the user 172.16.2.100 with their MAC address is this, and I'm getting from edge 2. So I'm in location. So edge router is representing the location here, edge 1, edge 2. And once the control node knows all this information, now it's time to communicate. The user is need to be sent the traffic. I mean, the user A is now communicate with user B. Which means now the next communication will happen with the help of the VXLAN. So we'll go for this, the one by one, the forwarding concept. So ultimately this is the, so once you deploy this, this is the goal, is that how the user is getting IP address, how they are communicating, what is the underlay control plane, overlay control plane, and data plane protocols. So now here, what we will do before to go for the next steps, we'll understand with the help of the lab environment. So up to this point in SD access deployment, in order to process this or deploy this SD access, So we'll do the lab number one here. So lab number one. Bring up your ICE. Bring up ICE server. I mean, use the initial configurations on ICE because that is not done in this lab. And then in the step number two, in the lab number two, integrate. I will say in more specifically, bring up DNAC. So DNAC installation is already done because that is the appliance you're going to be purchased. The software is predefined installed on that appliance. Where once you will deploy that DNAC in the data center, so you will access with the help of the URL. And once you access, then you will integrate. The next step is that you will integrate your ICE server with this. And of course, you have the next lab. So in today's class, you will perform these three labs. So then you will, with a DNAC, design the network. Design the network. So what you will do here, so make sure that so one by one you will do this lab. So lab number one, we will bring up the ICE server, which means the topology which is you will use here. So this is a topology. It is you're using. So notice once you access your the rack with the help of by taking the RDP session from this the jumper PC, which is hosted on this the vCenter. You will bring up the ICE server. And then also focus on the port number. So when you're going to be configure the initial configuration of ICE server, make sure that you're using this instead of this hash, you will use your port number. For example, you're getting port one, so it will be 11. Port 2, 12, port 3, 13. Okay, so when you're going to be doing this lab, out of you, one of can share the screen with me so that I can see that what is going on in this rack. So where the first is that do the initial configuration of ICE. And in the step number two, we'll integrate. So once we do the lab number one, then I will let you know that what is the minimum prerequisite is required so that successful integration we can do with the help of ICE to DNAC. But then in the lab number three, I'll let you know that what are the things you will do in the design network. And
integration ice with Jindak itself.
Come again, integration. So yes, you're saying about integration of ICE, something about this line. I didn't get it.
We should first do lab 3, yes, integration ICE with DNAC, then configuration of DNAC, yes, lab 2.
No, there is the DNAC, for the DNAC perspective, configuration is already the installed. So you will access this with the help of the URL. So I mean here when I'm saying this, so the approach here, this is the lab steps you will follow. So in the lab number ones, configure the initial Cisco ICE setup.
Yeah.
It means configure the ICE via the setup wizard and then apply a patch in order to fix the bug. And then in the lab number two, okay, so which is I'm saying lab number three, that is lab number two. So
yeah.
So in lab number two, you will build all this thing. So here is, let me change that. It's not like that. So this will be my lab number two. And that is integration. Integration ICE with DNAC is lab number three. Okay, so can anyone can share the rack with me so that you can verify, or I can also verify that.